Hello everyone, 1 second. Okay, hello everyone, this is John Jenkins, founder of Battle Gans and the late John Ford Entertainment, or I should say the delayed John Ford Entertainment. So, I'm doing flow charting today, so I learned flow charting for the first time when I was in college, and I think I got A in that class. I don't remember, but I think I got A in flow charting. So flow charting is basically when you have a graphical representation of the workflow of a computer program, and you have to come up with a way to make the computer program work on paper before you start coding. Now, I've already started coding my first game, which is Art Carrier Artang from my new company. But I never did a flowchart for this one. I never did a flowchart for anything outside of college. I haven't done a flowchart in almost about 18 years. I haven't done a flowchart in 18 years, but I did my first flowchart yesterday. I don't want to show you one I did yesterday, but I want to show you the one I'm doing working on today. So let's see. Alright. Okay, here's my Photoshop. Okay. And so this is what I have so far. So you have the start portion right here, and hold on a sec. Okay, let me see something. Okay, all right. So you have the start portion right here. And then it goes into play options or credits. I don't have a save or load function. I'm not sure if I can do that. I don't know if I want to do that for the first game. But I do have play options and credits. The reason why I don't want to have save or load is that I'm not sure if I'm able to save in the I'm not sure if I can save the game permanently, as in I think when I did the save function in the first Quinkai, I think it was only saved as long as the computer was on or as long as the browser was open. And then after that, I think it was in short-term memory only. I don't think it was in long-term memory, so I'll have to look into that. I'm not sure if I know how to save into long-term memory. That's the reason why I don't want to have save load in the first game. I might have to wait for that. So. Plus, it's not going to be a full game anyway because I'm just trying to get some exposure. So I'm not going to have a full feature game. I want to have a full feature game, but I'm not going to have one. So the play is right here. So I guess with play, I will have and this one is going to be a I want to have this be an input. So you got input. Okay. I choose Choose difficulty. I might have to switch these around a little bit. So, character. That's actually really true. I was just thinking that I should have a game style. So you know how in a Street Fighter game, the newer Street Fighter games, or any modern game really, there's more than one rule set for the game. So even if you're playing an electronic version of a game like Monopoly, so if you're playing Monopoly on a Nintendo Switch, that game's got dozens of gameplay modes that you can choose from. So, okay. Okay. Okay, game style. No, so let's go back to the brush. I probably should have done this in the pencil mode. But I'm so obsessed with the brush. Okay, so okay. Actually, yeah. Did I do this right? Yeah, choose it. These are all input. Yeah, okay. I did that right. All right, so options. Let's see. Okay. Screen size. All right. Obviously, I'm not going to be able to add a lot of this stuff because I don't really have a lot of time to do all this stuff. I'm not sure about this. Should I have difficulty in the options menu and in the? I don't know how that works. So when I play a game like Resident Evil 4, the difficulty is in the new game menu. So when you start a new game, you choose the difficulty. But is the difficulty I guess it's the same. Yeah, I guess it's the same. Yeah. So I guess it's the same. I guess it's the same. Okay. Difficulty. I think I did this wrong. I think each of these things is supposed to be a decision symbol, not a input output symbol. I think each of these is supposed to be a decision symbol, not an input output. I guess it's both, but you know, credits. Okay. So I'm gonna have. Credits animation. Okay, so that is, I guess that's a better version of okay. Okay, I guess that's a better version of the flowchart that I made yesterday. File, save as, okay, JPEG, carrier, Artane, flowchart 001. Okay. Duckling. So this is my first. This is technically my second. But it's the first real flowchart that I made for my new game. Why don't I open up? I'm gonna open this up. So this is the first flowchart that I made. This isn't really a good flowchart because I'm starting off with level one. I don't even know what that stuff means anymore. Or after level one. After start or rules or after death, I don't even know what all that stuff means. So, I'm glad I made a larger size for the second one. This one is 1024 by 768, and this is 1333 by 1333. So yeah, I'm glad I made this size bigger so that I could fit the actual words on here. So these are the I guess I probably could have typed some text into there with the text tool, but maybe I was being a little bit. I got the flowcharting symbols right there. I didn't even have to do all that. maybe I should make like a flowcharting. Yeah, that would be nice. So I didn't even have to do all that. All I had to do was make a special flowcharting thing, and then I could have just put the I could have just duplicated the same symbols over and over again. Well, okay, well, at least I got this done. So now I can move to the next portion, which is to actually start coding all this. Yeah, so, well, thanks everyone. And I'm gonna get started on this actual coding portion. Or maybe I should print this out. I didn't think about that. Maybe I should print this out, just so that I can have a copy of it. Man, this is gonna be tough to complete. I don't know if I can add all this stuff into the current version. I guess I gotta stick with what I got. I don't know. Well, I'll think about it. I'll think about it. Well, thanks to everyone for watching. Do not save. Thanks for everyone for watching. And have a nice day. Goodbye.